so quiet, this guy.
But also, it's what's interesting to notice, like, it doesn't sag at all.
Yeah. I mean, it turns like you actually hear it.
It's so quiet.
Yeah. I mean, it's a bit nice. Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's very good.
Very good stuff.
Wow, this is
what I find amazing is I'm still on 22 volts. Hello, today we are having a look at something I was actually not expecting to check out. I mean, 2 years ago we all tried to make a light racing platform. Not only back then there was no problem with regulation, but just to make it lighter and more efficient and more sensible. That was not possible due to components, but now you can get just perfect light racing quad from Beta FPV, and I'm gonna tell you why. First off, let's talk about the components. This quad is fantastic. 1805, very notchy motors, 1550 kV, branded by Beta FPV. They ship this quad with two sets of Genfan 5225, which is fantastic prop. Now just have a look at these guys. They had all the crashes you will see in this review on this one set. This is crazy, right? Oh look, maybe there's something, like a tiny bit. All the crashes in this video are on the same set of props. So anyways, fantastic motors, fantastic props, extremely skinny arms. Look,
perfect.
I have to move
test.
The cables out of the way so you can assess how skinny it is. Look, I will put a driver next to it. How skinny is this arm? That's only possible, obviously, because this quad is extremely light. This quad weighs 142 grams, so for a 5-inch racer, it's basically bananas grade. Now, it comes with a very nice pod, which Beta FPV updated to the feedback, which probably they received from more people than just me. So there is a little lip which protects the lens now. Fantastic, fantastic job Beta FPV. So now if you smack something going hand to the front, this will protect your camera and hopefully you will not eat it. You can fasten your camera and set the angle. This works pretty well, this doesn't move. I just tightened this and it works pretty well. What it also ships with is two mounts for your RX antennas with a cute blue little tip. And then you can angle it to match your flying style. I don't use it because I really like these antennas. This is a dipole from flexi dipole from Arturo. It just fits the bill. It's perfect. It's also very light. And the coax is quite hard, so you know, I don't have to worry that I will kill it or anything like it. It's a little bit flexible, which basically protects the antenna. But anywho, star of the show. Star of the show is not that skinny frame or a good selection of props or even very nice motors. The star of the show is by far this flight controller. I mean, you cannot see it, right? But I will just highlight the features. 35 amps, 326S, 32-bit, F4 FC with OSDM, you name it. This thing is single plate and it does all the tricks. So it's actually 32-bit, which is basically it's insane. So you can, this quad can comfortably run RPM, no sweat, right? How amazing is that? Single board, which can do RPM filtering. Super light as well. I mean, it must contribute to the weight. So they changed something. Obviously, it comes with a modern CMOS camera, and then there is a standalone VTX, which I have it loose because it doesn't really move that much. It's loose in the pod, and yeah, it does the job perfectly fine. No one complained about my signal. Online, I found some people complaining about this, that this clip is fairly easy to actually unclip or it moves. Someone said that it slides out. I mean, I adjusted in the most dumb and easy and also practical way. I just put some double-sided tape here, which prevents this thing from sliding out. All the crashes I had and you've seen already happened like that and it never popped out, so yeah, I'm quite happy. People ask me about durability. I crashed it a few times, I didn't break anything, but Beta FPV was smart and you have little screws and those arms are replaceable. Awesome, awesome design from Beta FPV. There is a nice little protection of the motor. I will show you now. Look, whatever you do, front or back, it's long enough and made light enough by this that you will not hit your motor. Now, why would you get this quad, right? I mean, sure, it's a 5-inch racer, it's quite light. I'm telling you already, it's actually more nimble and more agile than your average 5-inch racer, to a point where I had to drop my reins. I actually had to lower my reins to match how agile this quad is, so that's pretty awesome, right? I'm already queuing all the footage so you can see me trying to punish this quad. And then that leads me to Silent Star of the show. What do you use to power this guy, right? Well, in my case, use this. This is Beta FPV 556S 75C LiPo. You would think, hey, hold on, 75C is not that much, is it? Now, it is plenty. I cannot make this setup to suck. I just cannot make it suck. So basically, you know, I think we could easily slap 250 more kV on this guy, and maybe then we will be able to kill this LiPo. It's amazing how well it flies on it. You could probably risk getting 450 somewhere and fly it. So in this way, if you are technically inclined, you can totally take this guy and race against off-the-shelf or custom-built 5-inch racers people are using. I kid you not. I'm telling you straight away, it has slower top speed, but I'm also telling you that this thing is much more nimble. I mean, obviously it's crazy light, 102 grams plus 100 LiPo and then plus prop. Insanely light setup. So well done, Beta FPV. I really enjoy this quad. Check how quiet this quad is when it arms. It's just nothing. It's so quiet that you can comfortably glide in a park or, you know, just enjoy it without being worried that someone from 2 miles away will just hunt you down because you're generating noise. So well done, Beta FPV. I had to think very long about the negatives of the squad and I came up with something, so I'm kind of happy with myself, but it's a funny one because this LiPo is so good that you could probably risk increasing kV on this motor by 200. You would make it even more crazy, then a little bit more power hungry, and maybe then we could punish this LiPo to a point where I would actually be able to sag it. So yeah, fantastic quad, very good batteries, initial experience is fantastic. I had quite a few cycles and crashes on this guy. There is almost no sign. That's probably one other benefit of running a super light quad. I crashed this guy straight into flagpole. No sign, no problem whatsoever. How insane is that? This is not a new quad. Check it out. Maybe there is like a little scratch or something. Yeah. Oh, by the way, this is not a scratch. This is some vegetation I took with me, apparently. Anyways, fantastic job, Beta FPV. I cannot wait what will you release next. Knowing live, before I publish this review, you will release updated version with different... Oh yeah, of course they did. I think they released 2204 1700 kV motors, which probably would be sweet spot with this little LiPo. Or you could risk lighter LiPo and make it even more light and agile. So there you go, there you have it. I hope it answered all the questions you had about the quad. If not, hit me up, I don't mind replying. It's a fantastic quad, I don't mind sharing the info about it with you. So yeah, happy flying and until next one. Bye.